Hello there, my name is Ajiwe Isaac, and today we want to look at correction to the classwork given in the previous note. Still on partial fraction. All right, we are asked to resolve the complex fraction x cubed plus 5x plus 2 plus 5 over 2 open bracket x plus 1 close bracket. Open bracket s cubed plus x plus 1 and close bracket. We're asked to resolve this complex fraction into its partial fractions. All right, so the first thing to do is to identify the denominator, what we have, the factors in the denominator. And the factors, we have a linear factor and a polynomial factor. So when you have a linear factor, you only have a constant over the linear factor. Plus, when you have a polynomial factor, you start from the variable with a degree 1 less than the polynomial in the denominator. So that means we now have our complex fraction x cubed plus 5x plus 5 all over 2 open bracket x plus 1 close bracket. Open bracket s cubed plus x plus 1 close bracket equal to a over 2 open bracket x plus 1 close bracket plus bx squared plus cx plus d over x cubed plus x plus 1. And then we multiply both sides by the LCM. And so what we will get is x cubed plus 5x plus 5 to be equal to a into bracket x cubed plus x plus 1 close bracket plus 2 open bracket x plus 1 plus open bracket plus 2 open bracket x plus 1 close bracket open bracket bx squared plus cx plus d, then we close the bracket. So what we need to do at this junction is to open the bracket, collect like terms, and then compare coefficients. So when we open the bracket, use a to open the bracket. At the same time, you use x plus 1 to open the bracket. So by so doing, we have ax cubed plus ax plus a. When we use a to open the first bracket, and then when we use x plus 1 to open the second bracket, we have x open bracket bx squared plus cx plus d close bracket plus bx squared plus cx plus d. That is because it is multiplied by 1. So when we expand and collect like terms, all right, we have ax cubed plus ax plus a plus 2 open bracket b x cubed plus cx squared plus dx, then plus bx squared plus cx plus d. That's because we use x to multiply this bracket. So when we open the bracket by 2, what we'll get is ax squared plus ax plus a plus 2bx cubed plus 2x squared plus 2dx plus 2bx squared plus 2cx plus 2d. And then what we'll now do at deduction is to collect like terms. So we'll collect like terms. In collecting like terms, we have x cubed open bracket a plus 2b close bracket plus x open bracket a plus 2c plus 2d close bracket plus x square open bracket 2b plus 2c close bracket plus a plus 2d. So what we need to do is to compare the coefficients of the variables on the left hand side and on the right hand side. Okay, in comparing the coefficients, we'll see that here the left hand side, the coefficient of x cubed is 1. Whereas on the right hand side, the coefficient of x cubed is a plus 2b. We'll call that equation 1. Similarly, on the left hand side, The coefficient of x is 5. While on the right hand side, the coefficient of x is a plus 2c plus 2d. That means we now have a plus 2c plus 2d equals to 5. We call that equation 2. Also, there is no term for x squared on the left hand side. No term for x squared on the left hand side. And that suggests that the coefficient of x squared on the left hand side is definitely 0. And that is why there is no term for x squared. So the coefficient for x squared on the right hand side, however, is 2b plus 2c. And therefore, we have 2b plus 2c to be equals to 0. The constant on the left hand side is 5. And the constant, that is the terms without variable x on the right hand side, is plus a plus 2d. Therefore, we have a plus 2d to be equals to 5. And then we'll call that equation 4. From equation 3, if we take the 2c to the other side, we have 2b equals to minus 2c. If we divide both sides by 2, we have our b to be equals to minus c. And also from equation 4, if we make d subject, our d will therefore be equals to 5 minus a over 2. So if we substitute b, we substitute b for c and d for, and 5 minus a over 2 for d in equation 2. We therefore have a plus 2 open bracket minus b plus 2 open bracket 5 minus a over 2 equals to 5. And then if we simplify, 2 open bracket 5 minus a over 2 will give you 5 minus a, because the 2 will cancel out. And so you have a minus 2b plus 5 minus a. And then a minus a will give you 0. You take the 5 to the other side, becomes 5 minus 5. That's also 0. So eventually you have minus 2b equals to 0. And therefore, b is equal to 0. Since b is equal to 0, from equation, from b is equal to minus c, it simply means that our c is also equals to 0. Now that b is 0, c is 0. If you substitute that value into equation 1, our a will therefore be equals to 1. Since we know our a to be 1, our d will be equal to 5 minus 1 over 2. And that's 4 over 2, which is equal to 2. So our complex fraction is now being resolved into 1 over 2 open bracket x plus 1 close bracket plus 2 over x cubed plus x plus 1. How did we come about that? We only substituted the value for a as 1, b as 0, c as 0, and d as 2. So if you substitute the value for b as 0, then the x square in the partial fraction will go. If we substitute c as 0, the x in the partial fraction will also go. So leaving only d, which is equal to 2. That is our simplified fraction. For more clarity, you can write everything out line upon line. Listen to the explanation step by step, and then you will get to understand it better. It is usually better to write it out. Have a hard copy of this explanation. For more videos, you can go to my YouTube channel, madzik/YouTube, and download more videos on solved examples on this topic. There are also other topics therein. You can as well comment, subscribe, and share. I would recommend that you subscribe so that you can get notification of video uploads. I upload videos every day on different topics in further mathematics and mathematics. So you get notification when there is a new video upload. That way, you can keep yourself updated with my explanation. Not only that, you can recommend and you can share to your friends. And at the same time, we also render services for private lessons. Thank you.